Three things you need to know before you buy your first investment property, before you start playing Monopoly in real life. This is Full Disclosure. Number one, you need to understand that the interest rate that you're getting for the type of loan, an income property loan, is going to be slightly higher than it would be if you were getting a loan on a home you actually live in. So understand that because it could make or break your numbers when you're doing your analysis. So number two is make sure you're looking at a location that is actually desirable to rent in, because after all, the rent is what you care about. My suggestion would be to find an area that is near the highway, that's near jobs, it's near a hospital, it's near schools. That way you have a safety net if the likelihood of the market changes at all. If that happens, you're still gonna have an area where people want to be, so make sure that you're paying really close attention to the location. Number three is you wanna pay close attention to the utilities. For example, if there's only one water meter, that means everyone is sharing the same water meter, which means that the tenants cannot pay their own water bill. And you know who pays for that? You pay for that water bill, which means your utility bill is gonna be higher, which means that you're not gonna be cash flowing as much because you're going to have more operating expenses. And it's little nuanced tips like this that you really need to pay attention to when you're crunching your numbers. Now, if you're still with me, you are still with me, right? Here's a bonus tip. If you're looking for an income property and you wanna find a sleeper property where the realtor is either posting pro forma rents, which are projected rents, not the real rents, or worse, they're not posting rents at all. They're literally saying there is zero rental income. Well, that probably means that there is a long-term tenant. There's someone who's not paying market rents, and that means that people are overlooking these properties. And when a property has been sitting on the market for a long time, I smell opportunity. So I highly recommend you do a rental survey. Just find out what the bare minimum for what these places can rent is, and crunch your numbers, and you may find yourself a gem. Now, I know this is a lot to digest in about 3 minutes, and I hope you found it helpful. Send it to a friend, ask me some questions, comment below, and please don't forget to subscribe, because I want to provide you guys with more value. And if you want some one-on-one coaching to find an income property, go ahead, send me a DM. I would love to work with you. Bye for now.